Hey guys, so this video is going to focus on how to find a missing angle, specifically when you're dealing with vertical angles and supplementary angles. So first off, looking at the example that I have here on the screen, we have these two lines that intersect. And when they intersect, they create four spaces, right? One, two, three, four. Right, so using relationships that we know about angles, what we're going to have to do here is we're going to have to find the measure of each of the other three angles. So let's just call those A, B, and C. All right, so we're going to find the measure of angle A, the measure of angle B, and the measure of angle C, using what we know about vertical angles and supplementary angles. Now, I always like to start with vertical angles. My opinion, that's always kind of the easiest one to start with and to go with. So vertical angles are angles that are exactly opposite of each other. So when we have these two lines that intersect, this 40 degree angle here would be across from angle B there, making those two vertical angles. Angle A and angle C would also be vertical angles. And what we should know about vertical angles is that vertical angles are congruent. They are the same. So that means that if this angle over here is 40 degrees, that means that angle B also has to be 40 degrees by the definition of vertical angles. So that's how I'm able to find that one. Then what I'm able to do after this point here is use the fact that a supplementary angle equals 180 degrees. So a supplementary angle, so think of it as a straight angle here. It looks like a straight line, but the angle is going clear across one side to the other one. So kind of think about a semicircle. That's what this straight angle is. And straight angles equal 180 degrees. So what I can do is I can take my example that I have here and find any straight line. So you can use either one of them, and I'm going to use this one right over here. All right, and because it's a straight line, it represents a supplementary angle. Anything within this angle here would have to add up to 180 degrees because this is a straight line. So that means that A and B together would be 180 degrees. Well, we know that B is 40 degrees because it's a vertical angle with the one on the opposite side over there. So if B is 40 degrees, but we know that A and B together have to be 180 degrees, what we can do is we can take the 180 degrees that we know that entire angle is, and we can subtract away 40 degrees because we know that's what makes up A. So if we take this 180 and we subtract the 40, it's going to leave us with angle A. So 180 minus 40 is going to leave us with 140. So I can immediately state that angle A is 140 degrees. And if angle A is 140 degrees, then angle C also has to be 140 degrees because they are vertical angles with each other. So by using those two principles there, using vertical angles and supplementary angles, we are able to find the missing angles for this particular figure here.